44. Chapter 8. Magnus. Not realizing that the clock had eaten up so much time, Ingrid and Bob arrive just minutes before the matches began. Ingrid pauses their momentum. Here we are, we need to hurry, but first, I want to share with you an important insight. There is something about Magnus you should understand. He is a gifted soul. He possesses a rare and mostly forgotten aspect of our human potential. Magnus has what you might call a quantum computer for a brain. He can focus on many different things simultaneously. Most people today can barely stay on one thing at a time, never mind bi-auditory multitasking. Magnus can focus on literally dozens of sustained mechanizations at one time. Nikola Tesla possessed the same abilities. He would build a conduction motor in his mind, then run it for months just to see how long the bearings would hold out. Bob claiming his knowledge of the man being referenced, I named my latest computer simulator program after Tesla. All I'm saying here is bear with me when I'm with Magnus. My goal is to show him how to lend his talents to more than just chess. 45. He is literally playing like 20 games in his head right now, even when he is watching his football games. I am here for Magnus, and you. I don't even like chess, Ingrid reveals. Chess is simply a more complex version of tic-tac-toe. Whenever Magnus plays a game in his head or on a table against himself, it always ends in a draw. That is because Magnus has a unique type of brain. He cannot be beat, at least on the chessboard playing field against fellow humans most of the time. His cognitive abilities are unprecedented. Just as in tic-tac-toe though, if you do not make a stupid move, a blunder, then you can never lose. Chess is the same. The only thing that makes chess interesting or challenging is our human limitations. Sophie and Watson could, and probably have by now, played a million games. There will never be a winner, always a stalemate. I needed to learn chess to get Magnus to like and trust me so that I may help guide him towards his fullest potentials. One more thing, it might be a little tricky tonight because he's not too happy with me right now, most likely with you, too, but I need you to make friends with him. I know he seems reclusive, but once you break through, you are in. Let me guide you there. Now go get a champ, Ingrid cheers on. There you two are, we thought you were going to forfeit, Hikaru hurries them into the arena. Magnus was sitting front and center in the press booth, looking rather perturbed. Ingrid sent him a big love kiss smile as she sat at her table. 46. Bob, pretending not to see Magnus, kept his eyes laser beam focused on his chair, avoiding the gallery's glares. The floor manager pressed the timer signaling the match to begin at 9 o'clock on the button. Ingrid opens with queen's pawn d4. Bob responds with queen's pawn d5. His piece slips from his fingers kissing Ingrid's pawn, as he resets his piece onto the proper square, he looks up to see her send him a loving wink, and a nod. Let's have some fun, Bobby. With neither player able to gain advantage after 2 hours of solid play they agree to a draw. I am beat, see you all tomorrow, Magnus salutes, as he marches his way over to the elevator, then retires for the night. He is pissed, Hikaru clarifies, where the hell were you two? I know, we're sorry, Ingrid and I were. Bob attempting absolution, gets saved by the bell. I took Bob to see the Barcelona Cathedral, Ingrid grabbing hold of the wheel, we lost track of time, this is Bob's first visit to Barcelona, and I felt he deserved to see the city's most prized work of art. Oh sure, I get it, but you might want to tell that to Magnus, Hikaru recommends. He'll be fine, a little heartache drama will do him some good. He'll be sprite by morning, trust me, Ingrid wrapping up. Now maybe we should all get some sleep. It's been a long day. 47. Buenos noches. Buenos noches. Bob steps into the lift right behind Ingrid, then realizes that he needs to get back to the Catalonia. Where are you going, Bob, aren't you? Yes, of course, sorry, my bad, I'll grab a cab, see you all in the morning, Bob blushes. Bob, I have a suite with 2 bedrooms, Hikaru gleaming his offer, you're welcome to stay here for the night, no problemo. Oh no, I don't think so. I snore really loud and wouldn't want to ruin our friendship. No worries, man. I sleep with my headphones on, I won't hear a thing. Your choice, offer still stands. Sweet dreams, gentlemen, Ingrid casting her wishes upon the last 2 remaining, then disappears behind the sliding doors of the elevator. Well, alright, if you insist, thanks Hikaru. Hikaru and Bob settle in for the night, with no further incidents worthy of mention. Hikaru leans into Bob, as they analyze the leaderboard posted behind the registration tables, looks like you still have a chance to seat with Magnus Sunday, you do, too, Bob adds. 48. Yes, but you cannot lose or draw another game, Magnus shoots over their shoulders. Hikaru and Bob synced in unison, Buenos dias, Magnus. Hikaru prods in sincere curiosity, both turning around to face the man, did you sleep well, Magnus? I slept great and what a wonderful turnout today, look at all these people. Chess is becoming popular again, Magnus chippers. Yes, it is, thanks to Anna Taylor-Joy, also known as Molly Harmon, Ingrid injects, as she hands Magnus a bottle of water. It's funny how in all its history, and of all the great chess champions of the world dominated by a male patriarchy, that a young girl, a fiction at that, has sparked a new renaissance in a game that has become overshadowed in this new era of visual interactive chase em down, shoot em up, analog video games, Ingrid reminds the boys. Several applaud as Magnus's grin expands. Today the thinning starts, ladies and gentlemen. Matches begin at 10 o'clock this morning. Good luck to all our fine competitors, and may the best player win, cheers on the Fidey president, as he sits down for the traditional tournament breakfast. Bob intentionally sought Magnus out from the crowd as he enters the banquet hall. He was ready, and apparently Magnus was as well, to engage in a courting dance aspiring for to claim the king's admiration. 49. Engaging with the champ proved to be easier than he had anticipated. As the VIP guests who were clamoring for an autograph clear out, Magnus calls over. Here Bob, sit over here with us. Whoa, that was easy, Bob delights. He sat in the seat Magnus had reserved for him, Ingrid sat to his right. Bob, Ingrid was just telling me that you know Lydia, we visited her this past Wednesday, the day we arrived in Barcelona. She makes the best pea soup I have ever had. Do you agree? Yes, best pea soup I ever had, Bob mirrors. And her tea is invigorating, Magnus adds, nodding towards Ingrid. Bob glances over to Ingrid looking for signs of affectionate affirmation, you tried her tea. Yes, I did, best I've ever had. Bob attempts taking the lead in this dance, Ingrid tells me that you play games in your head, many at a time in fact. Magnus somewhat embarrassed pulls back, yes, I do, but not all the time. Do you have any other aspirations other than staying the chess champion of the world forever? 50. Funny Bob, of course. Ingrid and I are leaving for Munich right after the tournament. She has some friends she wants me to meet. They want me to explore new potentials for myself through transcendental meditation exercises and remote viewing techniques, combined with cognitive stimulus enhancements. All natural remedies, Ingrid reinforces. I am looking forward to our time together in Munich. Bob interjects, I'm headed to Frankfurt from here to join up with some old college buddies until the 9th. Maybe I could hook up with you lovebirds in Munich for the fest. Lovebirds? That might be an overstatement, Bob. We are really good friends, but lovebirds, not so fast my friend, Magnus asserting his independence. Bob thought, he called me friend, does this mean that I am in? Magnus will be terribly busy during his time in Munich. We most likely will not be able to enjoy the celebrations at Oktoberfest, Ingrid reclaims. That's cool, I get it, three's a crowd. Ingrid tosses Bob a what the fuck bomb that only Bob could see. No, no, what I meant to say was, I don't wish to impose, it probably wouldn't work for me anyways, Bob flails recovery. Damn, this is getting tricky, I need to take a step back, one more bad move and I'm all done.